Streamlit is a modern web framework for data science applications and the company founded around the framework's ecosystem. The development flow in Streamlit entails that every time you save some changes, Streamlit will be able to rerun your updated application, which enables a quick feedback loop during development. The data flow in Streamlit apps ensures that the entire Python codebase will be run when changes are made to either the code or the state of the widgets in the UI. Streamlit also offers ways to modify these behaviors using callbacks, such as onChange and onClick. Behind the scenes, Streamlit makes use of caching to speed up the entire process. The Streamlit write method, or stwrite for short, is one of the most powerful Streamlit features used for displaying and styling data. Stwrite can take different types of data as input and figure out the right way to display them. The supported data types include text strings, data frames, figures, charts, objects, models, and many more. Magic and magic commands enable developers to display almost anything without having to even use an explicit command like stwrite. Just type the variable name on a separate line and let Streamlit do the rest. Widgets help you input data and interact with your application. They include buttons, sliders, select boxes, text inputs, checkboxes, and all the other widgets you'd expect to use in a web or mobile application. Creating widgets is as easy as just instantiating a Python variable. This Streamlit variable will hold your inputs, which can be used in other operations, stored or displayed. The layout in Streamlit applications can be easily customized using layout methods, such as stsidebar to create a left panel sidebar for your controls, stcolumns to place widgets side by side, stexpanders to hide large content, and stprogress that can be displayed during long running tasks. Themes help you change the color scheme and the fonts within your applications. Streamlit comes with a default light theme and a dark theme, as well as the functionality to create and save your own custom themes. Caching allows your app to run faster when performing long-running tasks. Caching is performed by wrapping functions with the @stcache decorator, which checks all the code and the input variables passed to that function in order to decide to run that function again or to skip execution. Pages for multi-page apps in Streamlit are created by adding individual Python scripts within a pages directory next to the main page of your application called mainpage.py. The app model in Streamlit relies on several pillars. Streamlit apps that are essentially Python scripts that run from top to bottom, scripts that are re-executed on each page load, the fact that Streamlit will draw its output live as the script is run, caching, which is used for efficient and faster applications, scripts that are re-executed on each widget interaction, and multi-page applications that are built from individual Python scripts stored in a pages folder. Components are third-party modules that extend what's possible with Streamlit. You can use the component gallery to find components, install them as regular Python packages, or you can create and publish your own packages. To install Streamlit, it's recommended you first set up a local Python environment on your computer using conda, pip, pipenv, venv, or virtualenv. Or you might as well consider anaconda. First, you have to make sure that you installed a Python version, either 3.7 or above. Then you can install Streamlit using pip install streamlit. And you can test your installation by simply running streamlit hello, after which a hello app should appear in a new tab in your browser. To run Streamlit for a file named, say, myfile.py, simply use the command streamlit run myfile.py. To create a Streamlit app, we start a new Python file, we import Streamlit and the necessary packages at the top. We can then set the app title using sttitle. When we need some data to work with, we'll use the open source uber raw dataset. We create our load underscore data method, and then we'll use the load data function to load 10,000 rows of data in a pandas data frame. We can also add caching to our load data function using the decorator @st.cache_data to improve the performance. We can also use Streamlit to draw a histogram using our data. We can use stmap to plot our data on a map. To filter the data using a slider, we can simply use stslider. And finally, we can also use a button to toggle our data. We showed previously how we can create a single page app using Streamlit, but oftentimes a multi-page app is needed. To build a multi-page app, we start with our entry point file page, say home.py. We then create a folder named pages where we add the rest of our pages. The command streamlit run home.py will run our entire multi-page app. And this is how we split our existing Uber dataset single page app into a multi-page app with a home page, a plotting demo page, a mapping page, and a data frame page. So far, we showcased what Streamlit is, what it can be used for, and how it can be used. If you like this video about Streamlit and you would want me to create a series of more advanced videos on Streamlit, please like this video and subscribe to the channel. You should also click the notification bell if you want to be kept up to date with similar content. If there are any particular topics you'd want me to discuss in the the future related to data science or to Streamlit in particular, leave me a comment down below. Thank you.